We have some questions.
Cool. I think people are curious about angels. This is Tammy, who asks, do people really have guardian angels?
The Bible doesn't say that. The Bible says that they are ministering spirits sent forth to the heirs of salvation. Now, I believe that God has angels that are attending. We can ask for angels. Angels appear on the scene for people. There are warrior angels and others, but there's nothing in the Bible that I see that says every one of us has our own little guardian angel. I think that is, you know, stretching Scripture. Scripture says they're ministering spirits sent forth to the heirs of salvation. That's what they are. They're to minister to the heirs of salvation. All right.
Yeah, this is Pamela, who wants to know, what do angels do? Are they supposed to do whatever we command them to do? Is that how it works?
Well, the idea, angelos is a messenger. You know, the term euangelia means good news, and evangelism, good news. Mm-hmm. So the angels were messengers of God to bring truth to the people. And some I was reading today in Zechariah about major angels that were declaring certain truths taking place in Israel. And mm-hmm. their angel, the angel of the Lord, was there with Joshua, for example. You know, he led the armies. You look at Michael, who's the angel defending the people of Israel, and he you know, was in a war against the prince of Persia as he was bringing a message to Daniel. Mm-hmm. So you can go down the list, but the real name for angel is messenger. They're messengers of God.
This is one I've never heard before. Shonda says, my mother says Jesus was an angel before he was God's son. I disagree. Who's right?
Shonda, you are absolutely right. There's nothing in the Bible that indicates Jesus was any kind of an angel. You read Hebrews, it says he's above the angels. You know, the thing of it is, God has given us the privilege as heirs of salvation of being one day above the angels. Right now, we're under the angels. The angels are more powerful than we are. But Jesus was above all. He's the Son of God. He was never an angel. No way did he transition from being an angel to being God's Son. No way.
Okay, this is Miles, who says, is there any scriptural basis to the belief that angels can heal us?
I'm trying to think right now. I think angels have enormous power, and there's no reason why they can't. I think if they touch you, you know, I'm thinking of... I believe it was Daniel. An angel appeared to him. I mean, he fell faint. He was in a swoon. The angel was, but why not? The angel lifted him up, gave him strength. So I think angels have the power to bring healing, but I can't give you chapter and verse right now. I'm sorry.
Hey, this is Heather, who wants to know, why do some people get to see angels and other people don't?
Well, in the book of Corinthians, there are certain enablements or manifestations of the Holy Spirit. One of them is called discerning of spirits, and it is not discerning of demons, and it's not discerning of angels, but nevertheless, there is an enablement of the Holy Spirit which gives us the ability to see into the supernatural world. Nathaniel was there with Jesus, and he said, saw you when you were under the tree, and Jesus said, well, the time's going to come, you're going to see the angels of God ascending and descending on the Son of Man. There are manifestations many, many times in the Old Testament where angels appeared to various people. They were called theophanies and some other term, but they were called the angel of the Lord. Many times it was God himself, or it was a manifestation of Jesus. Otherwise, it was just angels. But nevertheless, they do appear, and it's up to them to appear. But why do they appear to some people? I mean, I don't know. I'm trying to think of an angel appeared to Mary, hail, highly favored of the Lord. Mm-hmm. And, you know.
So. This is Renee, who says, when people describe angels, they say they wear white and have wings. But doesn't the Bible describe some types of angels as just being giant wheels with eyes? What gives?
That was a vision of Ezekiel, and he saw wheels within wheels and having eyes. It doesn't say they're angels, but...
Beings. He said,
they were
right.
Beings, but not necessarily angels. But if you look at the diagram of an atom... It looks like that. You know, you see those little circles,
wheels
within wheels. Mm-hmm. And I think God was giving his servant an understanding of the way the world works, but that wasn't necessarily angels. Mm-hmm. But they don't have to have wings.
Yeah.
So, I mean, some of these beings, you know, they have a head like a man, a head like an ox, and wings like, you know, it goes down the list of some of the attributes.
Okay, this is Bart who says, angels can sin, right? That's what happened to Lucifer. Can they still do wrong? Can they still make mistakes? Can they intervene on our behalf and do something for us that's against God's will?
No, I don't think they can do that. I think, but clearly demonic. You see, all the angels were there, and they were all in God's presence, and there were supernatural beings that he had created. And then Satan, the Bible says he was overwhelmed with the sense of his own beauty, and pride came in, and he began to think, I can do a better job of running the universe than Almighty God can. And so he rebelled. And if you read certain passages in Revelation, it looks like he took a third of the angels with him. So there was this tremendous revolt in heaven, and it was led by Lucifer, who was that meant the light one. And he became Satan, that's the adversary, or, you know, the devil, you know, Diabolos, which is, you know, the other name, or Abaddon. You got a number of names for the devil himself, but he was the leader of these fallen angels. So the question was, can they do wrong? Well, yes, they did wrong, and they fell, and they are condemned to hell. And the Bible says that hell was prepared for the devil and his angels. So they know what's happening. Jesus was talking to some devils with a man that was a Gadarene demoniac, and he let them go into the pigs, and they said, don't send us to the pit before the time. They knew they were going. They knew their end is coming. And when they do, they'll be tormented forever and ever and ever. And the big thing is, human beings should not have a part in hell, because that was set up for the devil and his angels. So, but the angels who follow God, can they do wrong? Yes, they have free will, but do they? No, they don't. At this point, they're pure and they're holy, like the seraphim.
The decision's been made. The die's been cast.
That's right. And they know the consequences. So I don't think that you're going to see them rebelling against God.
Well, that's all the time we have for your questions on angels today. We thank you for that. You know, throughout this week, we're running poll questions on our website. Yesterday's question was, do you believe that God still heals like he did in the New Testament? The results, 98.78% said yes, I believe in miraculous healing.